This is Mira, and today I'm going to talk about poetry. Understanding poetry. Prose is the form of language that has no formal metrical structure, and it is written or spoken language in its ordinary form. Poetry is the sound and meaning of words that combine creativity, express personal feelings, thoughts, ideas, and experiences. It is organized in lines and stanzas. Lines are similar to sentences, and stanzas are similar to poems. Now we are going to see the structural elements in poetry. Rhyme, rhythm, and repetition. Rhyme and rhythm are some of the most important elements in poetry. Repetition actually is the basic of many poetic devices. This is rhyme. These words sound the same but spelling differently. Example, pew, show, glue. Rhythm and rhyme. The more that you read, the more things you will know. The more that you learn, the more places you will go. Dr. Sears. Pieces to know about poetry. Rhyme. Words rhyme if they sound alike. Poems are rhymes at the end of lines. Rhyme scheme is the pattern of rhymes in a poem. Usually letters are used to indicate which lines rhyme. Poetry does not always have to rhyme. Rhyme, for example, we are going to use letters in a rhyme scheme. Twinkle, twinkle, little star, how I wonder what you are. Up above the world so high, like a diamond in the sky. When the traveler in the dark thanks you for the tiny spark. If you notice, the star and R matches, the sound matches, so we are going to use letter A. High and sky sounds matches, so we are going to use B. And dark and spark, we are going to use C, because the sound is similar. Now we can continue with rhyme schemes. I do not like green eggs and ham. I do not like them, some I am. I do not like them in a boat. I don't like them in a boat. I don't like them in a house. I don't like them with a mouse. If you notice, ham and am, goes, the sound goes together. Boat and goat, the sound similar. And house and mouse matches it out. Now we are going to see some samples of repetition. Thanks, Mom. Thanks, Dad. Thank you, Mom. Thank you, Dad. Three small words. So much to add for all your love and your support. A million words will be too short. The words I love you seem too few. The express to love that I have for you. Rhythm is the flow of the beat in a poem. It is the meaning measured motion. Both spoken and written language contains rhythmic patterns. You can create rhythm by rhyming words, by using repetition, or by changing the length of the line. When rhyming, poems also have a rhythm in the words, but they are much more fun. Here we have some examples of rhythm. It was the best of times. It was the worst of times. It was the age of wisdom. It was the age of foolishness. It was the epoch of belief. It was the epoch of incredulity. It was the season of life. It was the spring. You can create rhythm by rhyming words, by using repetition, or by changing the length of the line. You may have a short line followed by a long line, or long line, long line, but the short line. That creates a type of rhythm and patterns that brain can't follow it. Rhythm is all about sound. Can be made by a number of things, repeated phrases, syllables, pause, and rhyme. Poetry can be fun. Write about it and to think about it. Poetry can be really inspiring and can be really uplifting and definitely can be used to communicate to different people. Don't be afraid of poetry. Find something you like and enjoy about it. Give it a try. Now we are going to have some questions. Does this poem have rhyme, rhythm, and repetition? Why did the author choose to create that in this poem? And how does it enhance the meaning of the poem? Those are the questions you already have. It's already distributed. Thank you.